free potential surface. Let's see what is equipotential surface. A surface at which each point has same potential is called equipotential surface. For example, if we have a positive point charge, we can draw a spherical surface around it, and you choose any point A, B, C on this surface S1, these all points are having same potential because radius of sphere is same for all these points, and potential due to a single point charge is kq over r. So q is not changing, r is not changing, k is constant. So a spherical surface around a positive charge is an equipotential surface. Likewise, you can plot as many spheres, concentric spheres around it. Each concentric sphere around a positive or negative charge will be an equipotential surface, right? In itself means potential at any point lying on surface 2 will be same. It does not mean potential of point A lying on surface S1 is equal to potential of point D which lies on surface S2 or sphere S2. These are not the same. Now let's see properties of equipotential surface. What are the properties? As we say, potential of point A and B are same, since VA is equal to VB is equal to VC, it means potential difference delta V or dV in differential format is zero. So the potential difference between any two point lying on equipotential surface is zero. Second, you can say we know work done W is equal to Q into potential difference. So this is also zero. So this is second property you can easily define, that work done in moving any point charge in between two points of lying on equipotential surface is always equal to zero. Third, we can see, we know this, since electric field is defined as potential gradient. Come here now. Since electric field is defined as potential gradient, so potential difference is equal to minus dr, right? And at equipotential surface, what is zero? dv is zero. This shows E dot dr is zero. This shows electric field is always perpendicular to the dr. That is, electric field is perpendicular to every point lying on equipotential surface. I repeat, electric field is perpendicular to every point lying on equipotential surface. Now see, this is third, fourth is same, no two equipotential surfaces can intersect each other. Reason is same as that of, because if two equipotential surfaces intersect, you will have, you can draw two tangent at the point of intersection, that is two directions of electric field, which is not possible. Equipotential surface appears crowded in the region of strong electric field. Next property, equipotential surfaces appear crowded in a strong electric field region. Now you can see the different shapes of the equipotential surfaces obtained. Due to a single point charge or system of point charge. Alright, let's do one very simple conceptual question. Electron revolving around a nucleus in an atom, isolated atom structure by Bohr. This electron does not gain energy, no change in kinetic energy. This was the statement, energy is conserved or it remains constant, energy is constant, right? How can I say, this orbit in which electron is revolving is equipotential surface because nucleus carries positive charge which is located at the center. So work done in between any two points you choose A and B is zero, and when work done is zero, then from work energy theorem, no gain energy, no change in energy. Let's do quickly exercise 2. What does it do, exercise 2? There is a uniform electric field, strength 3 into 10 raised to the power 6 newton per coulomb. A charge of 2 micro coulomb is moved from A to B, then B to C, then C to A. This is 3 centimeter, this is 4 centimeter, this is 5 centimeter, this is 90 degree. What do you have to calculate? Calculate work done between AB, BC and AC. How do you calculate work done just here? Work done from WAB first. Work done is F into X, right? F is equal to Q into E. X, Q is 2 micro coulomb minus 6. Electric field is 3 into 10 raised to the power 6 newton, 3 centimeter, 10 raised to the power minus 2 meter. 6, 12 into 10 raised to the power minus 2 joule, that is 0.12 joule. Work done between B and C is 0 because this is a plane perpendicular to uniform electric field, and plane perpendicular to uniform electric field is an equipotential surface. I repeat, BC, B point B and C lies on a plane perpendicular to electric field. So these both points are lying on equipotential surface. So potential of B is equal to potential of C. That means delta VC is 0, delta B is 0. So if we do Q into delta V, it is 0. No work done in the second situation. From A to C, work done will be same as 0.12. This question is also asked in the board examination. How do we calculate work done from A to C is same 0.12? You see, potential of point B and potential of point C are same. Potential of point A has some different value. Therefore, you can write, since potential difference between A and B is equal to potential difference between A and C. Charge into potential difference into AB, you can use this formula here also. You have already calculated work done, so there is no